A massive plume of smoke blanketing the skies over the Lake Independence area of Belize City, a roaring inferno consuming the structure that once stood here on Estella Metzgen Street on Sunday morning. Fortunately, no one was injured. Firefighters responded to the scene and battled the fire the best they could. Station manager Kenneth Murty says the cause is electrical.
This one wooden structure, it was in the care of a local Belizean because the owner was in the U.S. And then the fire department was made to understand that the occupants of this particular building became squatters themselves. They made comfortable in this home that wasn't rightfully theirs. Again, the evidence showed that this building had the wiring coming directly from the BL pole to their structure and then subdivided within the various rooms. It was another unfortunate Sunday afternoon, Sunday mid-morning, whereby again the electrical breakdown consumed this building and then created massive damage, displacing two family members to the neighboring structure. One, Mr. Palace, who was the sole occupant of the upstairs structure, and a lady, Miss Cruz, and her 10-year-old minor, they were the occupants of the lower flat.
The building was destroyed, leaving the occupants displaced.
These people were displaced by the fire, and the building was owned by Mr. Mark Burgess, so he himself sustained massive loss as a result of this fire Sunday morning.
So were anybody injured in these fires?
Fortunately, no injuries were reported to the fire department, and then I say fortunately because when we arrived on the scene, we were told that just before the fire erupted into the massive inferno it did, the occupants of the building were seen fleeing the building, so fortunately nobody was hurt in this blaze.
And the blaze, while consuming the first structure, spread to the adjacent house belonging to Mark Burgess. He says that firefighters could have done much more to control the blaze, but that's difficult, especially given uncontrollable factors such as wind gusts and wind direction.
Our initial team made a defensive effort to the south of the current structure. The wind direction was blowing in a southeasterly fashion, so we had to do fire coverage exposure for that close building. It was in the blink of an eye that the breeze then turned it direction, and unfortunately that was when Mr. Burgess' property caught fire. Strategic location is key on the initial stage, and once we execute that and we have to relocate and readjust, that's where time consuming effort comes in. I understand Mr. Burgess's complaint, I understand his concern. We do not control the element of the weather. We cannot respond to an emergency fire scene and tell the breeze be still. We don't have that power to do so. All I can say is I am at a loss that he had to suffer the loss because of Sunday morning's event.
And the event, as terrible as it was, could have been much worse.
Rightfully so. It could have been a whole lot worse. In these kind of work, you never want to walk away knowing that you lost more than what you actually responded to. We responded initially to one structure and we walked away losing two. It's an unfortunate situation for the owner, Mr. Burgess, and it goes to shows whereby our efforts, as pleasing to some as it may seem, will always be disturbing to others.
None of the buildings were insured. Reporting for Love News, Hipolito Novelo.